While Donald Trump certainly likes to portray himself as a real populist alternative to his opponent, Nikki Haley, a more conservative, traditional Republican, he's actually courting big dollar donors, just like she is. So last Thursday, Trump actually attempted to court casino executive Miriam Adelson for campaign cash. She and her late husband, Sheldon Adelson, certainly did provide quite a bit of money to Donald Trump in previous elections, previous campaigns. For instance, they first gave him $25 million for his 2016 presidential campaign. The Adelson family emerged as the biggest backer for the then businessman. Then following the 2016 campaign, according to Time, Adelson was pleased with Trump's move of the US embassy from Tel Aviv and into Jerusalem. A year later, after the Adelsons had given $87 million to help Republicans in the 2018 midterm elections, Trump awarded Miriam Adelson the nation's highest civilian honor, the Presidential Medal of Freedom, which we've talked about this on the show before, but it still shocks me every time. Like, yeah, he just sold it. He just sold it to them, right?
Yeah, if you don't like corruption, you don't like the swamp, then you should despise Donald Trump. He'll do anything for money and he'll do anything for the Adelsons. He's Adelson's bitches.
Now in 2020, the Adelsons gave $430 million to conservative groups, including $90 million to the pro-Trump super PAC, as he was running for reelection in 2020, of course.
So I talk a lot about this in my book. There's a whole section devoted to it, tyt.com/justice if you want to get the book. So the Adelsons also gave him over $100 million in 2016. So they bought him lock, stock and barrel, and he did like half a dozen giant wish lists that they had. The Sheldon Adelson was a crook and he had bribery charges against him in China, but he could bribe Trump into dropping the charges against him that was related to bribing foreign officials. It's a US law, but the president gets to kind of dismiss that law as long as he's bribed. So you can't bribe foreign officials, but you could bribe US officials. And Donald Trump, he'll get bought for anything. I mean, he's a common prostitute. And so, and for $100 million, he threw in everything. Tax cuts, estate tax, anti-union, getting rid of internet gambling to help his casinos. And then at the end, like a tchotchke, if you act now, I'll throw in Ginsu knives and a Presidential Medal of Freedom for your wife. And so now he's going back to kiss her ass and say, yep, please give me more bribes. So this is your legendary populist Donald Trump, and he's now kissing the ass for of Club for Growth as well. We won't tell you who they are.
We might have millions of people watching this show, but you can be the difference maker, because we just need 1% of our audience to be paid members, and then this show can be around forever. So you can make that difference. Click join now.
I'm just amused at the surface level difference between Nikki Haley and Donald Trump, because Nikki Haley also met with Miriam Adelson just last fall. So they're courting the same donors, meaning they're very likely going to be bought by the same individuals and the same moneyed interests. Now let's get to David McIntosh. So last Wednesday, Trump also met with Club for Growth, Club for Growth President David McIntosh. And no, Club for Growth is not like, every time I hear it, I think of like hair growth,
plants, right?
Right? Yeah, no, yeah, it's about tax cuts. That's what this group is mostly concerned with. Now, Trump's history with McIntosh and the organization is kind of mixed, right? They didn't start off on a good foot. Club for Growth spent millions on anti-Trump ads back in 2016 because Trump wasn't considered conservative enough for them. At the time, McIntosh said the following: Trump has advocated higher taxes numerous times over many years, just like he's advocated for universal health care and the Wall Street bailout and expanded government powers to take private property. But as we all know, Donald Trump might say that kind of stuff on the campaign trail, but once he was elected, what was the one thing he did accomplish? The 2017 tax cuts for the rich. He cut the corporate tax rate from 35% to 21%. And then he cut the tax brackets for the highest earners in the country as well. But years later, McIntosh and Trump actually made up and they worked as allies. They broke up again during the 2022 midterm elections when the two backed different candidates in various congressional races. But Trump And Trump, by the way, wasn't invited to the organization's annual donor retreat last year. But the Club for Growth, or the Club for No Growth, he said at the time, an assemblage of political misfits, globalists, and losers fought me incessantly and rather viciously during my presidential run in 2016. They asked to get together on endorsements of candidates. We did and had many wins and no losses. Relationship broke up over my endorsement of certain great people in Alabama and Ohio. I won them all. So they had a tiff over which congressional candidates to support. But in the end, it appears that Trump is trying to court him again. And considering the fact that it's very likely that Trump is gonna be the Republican nominee, he's probably gonna secure some money from Club for Growth and from McIntosh.
If you're wondering why Club for Growth wasn't interested in Trump in the first place, because that group is the number one group that represents rich people. So they've been arguing for tax cuts for the rich and for corporations for as long as I've been covering politics. And they're very, very effective. Oftentimes they pick who the presidential pick is gonna be for the Republicans. And they did when it was McCain and Bush, and they picked Bush because he would serve them without questioning. And McCain said he was a maverick who would make independent decisions. So they're like, we don't want independent decisions. And that is partly why they were against Trump. And if you think, hey, that proves that Trump is principled, what are you talking about? He just said that they were globalist loser misfits, and now he's going to work with them.
He's begging them for money.
He's begging them for money.
Yeah.
What happened? I thought they were globalists, the evil and losers and all that. Now you're kissing their ass and groveling to them. So why didn't they want to give him money in the first place? Because Trump is not a good guy, but he does corruption only on his behalf. They like politicians who do corruption on their behalf and only their behalf. Okay, so they're like, oh, this guy's taking a piece of the action. We don't want that. So why did they work with him during the Trump administration? Because Trump then said, okay, peace. I'm gonna do giant tax cuts for the rich and for corporations. They're like, there you go, attaboy. We knew you were a corrupt son of a bitch. Well, that's just like we like it. And so they gave him a ton of money. Then they have the disagreement, as Anna explained to you. And now they're back to making up because they realize, oh, we can't beat him. And what did Trump promise? Was one campaign promise so far. Another giant corporate tax cut. So Club for Growth is back. The Adelsons are back. They're like, good, good. Our little servant boy, the little orange boy is back. Pretending to be a tough guy, but in reality, working for us. That's who that populist is.